YouTubers, coming to you from Centralia once again. It seems to be the hot spot for YouTubing. I'm here supposed to be for a meetup. I came a little late. They started at 11. It's now around 12. So I guess we'll just take a walk around till we meet up with them. I do have my drone. I might get some drone footage. Maybe use that to try and find them, but oh well, come along with us. We're gonna take one last look at Centralia. Adam Tereska set up this meetup because he's going to be moving to Texas. And until I meet up with them, we'll just scout around some areas here. Let's take a look, all right? Okay, the first place I stopped here is the first, let me see a sign here, First United Methodist Cemetery. And they take donations to keep this going. Let's take a quick walk around in here. Now, if you know about Centralia, I think it was in 1963, they had, turn around, they burned garbage in a coal pit. And of course that caught the coal mines on fire. And ever since then it's been burning. The homes have been eminent domained, which means they took the rights to their houses and as they sold, let me see if I can get this right. They sold the houses to the government to get money out of it because they couldn't sell it to anybody else because of this fire. But so now it's pretty much 5 homes left. They're allowed to stay and that's it. They can't sell their home. They can't do nothing with their property. But yeah, this cemetery is in pretty good shape. If you look around here. Excuse the wind noise if I'm getting any in my audio. But I don't seem to be up here. And I was just talking to some people up here. They're doing a ham radio broadcasting up here on top of the hill. It's a good place to do. Alright, so I don't see anybody up here. We'll go over to St. Ignatius Church, which isn't there anymore. It got torn down. I think that was back in late 90s they tore it down. There's a book I borrowed about all the history of Centralia. It shows the old buildings and stuff. I'll put that in the description for you. It's a good book to look at if you're really interested in Centralia. Another car coming here, a couple more. This must be the ham radio guys coming in. Alright. I'll just keep looking for these guys. And until I see anything, I'll get back to you. Yeah, when you walk around here, this used to all be homes. There's one of the test pipes they have in the ground. But everywhere you see like a road, like that would have been an alley. This would have been a road. Houses would have been on either side. Once was a nice neighborhood. I don't know what kind of bird that is. But I saw some people up here. So I'm going to take a quick walk up here and see who is up here. Hopefully it's them. This was like the worst area that got hit with the fire in the past. As you can see, all the tar bulldozed off to the side. Alright, let's see if we can find them. Yes, I found them. Right up here. And we'll meet up with them and introduce each other.
This could have been somebody's house here. You had pavement here for a driveway. Kind of a building was here, I'm not sure what, but probably somebody's house. He's happened to catch that out of the corner of my eye.
What kind of bird is that?
Not sure. If Cliff was here, he'd tell us.
Yep. Yes, he would. I'm surprised he didn't show up.
Jeffy knows.
Yeah, right.
good. He uses a lot of stuff from his field guide, as he mentions a lot of the time.
You got Mr. G. Adam's there in the black shirt. Jamie Megan in the green shirt. How you doing?
Good.
Simply Explorin's here.
How you doing?
Mr. Smithnet, Jake Smithnet. And we got a guy in an orange shirt, I don't know.
Mark.
Mark? Okay, good enough.
Either a driveway, maybe even a parking lot for a small business or something.
And Matt's up there, he was flying his drone when I got here. And this is Locust Street, right? Yep, JP Video's here. How you doing, JP? I know this guy, I just saw one of his videos. How you doing?
Hey man, I'm Nick.
Goldcracker. Nice to see you again.
How you doing, Chris?
Yep, let you. I didn't want to shake your hand while you're flying the drone. That'd be awful.
Yeah, I got some cool hand shots of the church.
You must got a cool rack.
I thought you were
going to hit the tree.
I want to try it. I'm a little nervous yet. I flew around the high bridge. It was all right, but down by where I work, I flew it and it took off on me. Found it, but okay, what happened here?
I didn't buy a drone, so bad.
Got this test pipe.
Oh.
It says down in cement, do not back over with tour bus.
I hope I'm not in your way.
You're fine. You're fine.
I believe they drilled some long lines, about 1,800 of them. And what they'll do is they take this cap off and they put a thermometer down there and they use that to track where the fire was going.
Wow.
There is a metric crap ton of these things all over the place. Even down on Park Street where it's safe, they had the boreholes down there. And as I was bringing up before, this is about the approximate area here, this road here, of where the water table that runs east to west in town goes. And that's what kept the fire from coming up this way, because it's actually protecting the town. So if the government was honest, they could have turned around from Park Street, which is the next street over north. They could have said, no, you're not eligible, you're not in the danger zone. The town would only lost the bottom three blocks.
They want that coal.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
They want that coal.
They want that coal.
Now, how many, the veins kind of fold over a couple times under here, don't they?
Yeah, they do.
Because I know I was at the anticline down in Ashland, and that's impressive to see, and I can imagine what it's like under here.
Yeah, if you watch the 1982 PBS special on Centralia, they have all the maps on that.
Okay.
There is a ton of veins down here, but... It's not as, but the fire was going in a south-southwest direction down that way, and that's how why it's underneath the, it's another graffiti highway, why they eliminated Burnsville, and there's also a 20-home village called Germantown on the main drag here heading down to Ashland. That got taken out as well.
I think that
was taken out more so because of precautionary measures, if you want to call them that, than actual fire. But when I talked to members of DEP in 2017, they said in the current direction it's going, it's going to miss Coltmont, it's going to miss Ashland, and basically where we saw the steam, where we filmed steam in the past, down on Big Mine Run Road, it's actually a ventilation backdraft because the fire was starting from the east and went west.
Oh.
And a lot of people keep thinking the fire's moving east, but it was on the eastern edge of town, and it's been out from underneath the town for quite a while.
I remember I was 14 when I first came through here to see this. And that's when there were houses here.
Yeah.
But the steam was coming out the mountainside as you go down the road here and stuff. We're like,
yeah, I mean, the steam was parking out of over here.
Mm-hmm.
But like I said, with all the way the vent systems were.
You know, I remember when I came through the road, we were coming from Bloomsburg Fair, coming down the road, and I had a bag phone in the car at the time. And my friends were like, call 911, call 911. I said, I guess that's what you got to do. And they said, get out of there as far as you can get it from this place. But then I stood there, someone took video of it and has it on YouTube, I saw.
Yeah, Jay's got a video. He found a VHS tape.
Yep, at the mayor's house.
Mm-hmm.
The abandoned mayor's house.
Where we're parked right now, in fact.
That's where it was, okay.
Yep, matter of fact, my car's in the living room.
Yay.
Yeah, I remember seeing that video of Jay's.
Yeah.
You know Lou Greco, don't you?
I heard of him.
He cuts a lot of the grass around here.
Okay.
He's about 80 years old, and that's all he does. And I service his equipment, but that's all he does. He goes, oh, yeah, I remember so-and-so lived here, so-and-so. He rattles off all the names. I thought, oh, that's got to be so heartbreaking.
Yes, it is.
I can't imagine.
No, yeah. Like I said, I brought up John Lokaitis. He lived on Park Street. And
He's still
down in Ashland now.
He still does the decorations at Christmas time and stuff?
Yeah, I did a video on that this past December.
Some diehard people that live here.
No kidding.
Yeah, the four-way intersection. I got a video on that. There's a manger.
During the holiday.
Yeah.
Does he still live up here?
He lives all the way down in Ashland.
Okay. He finally moved out.
Well, he got thrown out in 2009.
Oh, man.
I saw a documentary that he was here.
He found it was, yes.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah, that's an excellent one. I got a lot of information off of that. Then I got books and whatnot. Pick up even more information. And, he and, I believe it was a history teacher named John Kormaninsky. He got thrown out of here Memorial Day weekend, and Lokaitis got thrown out of here Thanksgiving weekend.
Jeez.
Matter of fact, it was the day after Black Friday. He tore his house down.
That is a Black Friday.
That brought a whole new meaning to Black Friday.
But then you go down to the garages, they're still up. There's someone's shaker box still there when they were bootlegging mine from their backyard. I know the guy.
That's on Big Mine Run.
He used to cut the grass up here at St. Ignatius.
I have videos of that. Jay's got videos of that.
Mm-hmm. The guy said, if you want to come up and take it. It's like, I don't think you can. It's cemented into the ground, he said. He said, if you want to take it.
If I would take that shaker if I could.
But it's...
Because that's a piece of history.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I cleaned it up and make sure everything was good. I was telling the guy right here where the gas station is.
Mm-hmm.
The concrete slab there, that's where the uprights were for the overhead.
Yeah.
And then the building is where the grass starts.
Now, don't they have that island down Graffiti Road? There was that oval cement piece, I think, was the island. They must. I think so. I don't know. It looks like a gas station island.
It very well could be.
Where they move stuff around here.
That's where the...
That's where the gas station was. That must have been awful to check the gas and in your... Why is the gas so hot? No, thank you.
And then right across the street is where Todd Domboski fell through.
Okay.
As a matter of fact, it's taken down to there while we're heading over towards the cars because we're going to go to a couple different spots.
Okay.
Cool. We'll take it through the woods there because it's not far at all. And then we'll... somebody even had the decency to paint it big, glow orange.
So which one is
the vent pipe?
Oh yeah, I remember. I think I saw one of your videos. You spotted it in there.
Yep,
that's something.
I saw it before the painting. Cool. It's crazy. The only unfortunate thing is I had a book that has a map of the danger zone. It's
okay.
The other car's in Texas.
That's a little bit of a haul.
I'm moving down there, so I had to get the car down there anyway, but I forgot the book was in that car, not the black one.
Last year, I went up the road behind 425, and I was in the first open-air car, and I was using...
Hey, we're going to look at the spot. Oh, I can't remember his name.
Todd Domboski.
Where he was visiting his grandmother's place at the time. This was... What was this, back in the
89? 81.
81, I was way off. All right, here it is. Wow. They piled the dirt up.
Yeah, the vent pipe is there to allow the vent gases to get out of there so it wouldn't expand and contract it continuously.
Mm-hmm. Nothing's coming out now, I guess.
No, nothing's coming out of it now. It's, at best, it's air temperature now.
But at the time, they put that in there to keep, like I said, to prevent expansion and contraction, which would have caused this all fall back in.
Yeah, right. And, yeah, they just had a collapse down by the intersection last year, I saw.
Yes, they did. Yeah. And that was just a case of a mine.
The mine
was over here.
Mm-hmm.
And that approximately where that low spot is there.
Uh-huh.
And whatnot. So that's where the house was. It's a decent-sized backyard.
Not much of a yard anymore.
No, not the forest.
Like the pine trees could give away it. There was a house.
Yeah.
Why, they're not native, right?
I don't believe so.
Okay. Neat.
These have prone to subsidence.
Hmm. I thought there might have been an abandoned mine in here or something that they closed up.
No, this is
just for the houses.
There are four houses here. And they were the first ones to get torn down in the 1980s.
Wow.
And then where my Milan is over there, that was Mayor Tom Walmer's living room.
Okay. Right there was his house.
Oh, I got something else I want to show you.
Okay.
This is something you'll find really crazy. There's a swing set to this property here.
Uh-huh.
If you come over to this side,
there's
look at that pipe.
Yeah.
It's going through the tree.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it grew in.
Yes,
the tree grew around it. Wow, I got a real good shot, everything blended in. Almost looks like a branch.
Yeah.
That is cool. Shows how long that's been in there.
Yeah, right.
That's gotta be a good, 30 years?
At minimum.
The growth?
Next.
You want, Jay?
Well, I don't know if you saw this or not, I showed you this too.
Yeah, that's Nick's crossing. I couldn't remember your name.
It's
okay,
I'm Nick.
Embedded into the tree.
Yeah, I can see where it used to be on this side, but nature's reclaimed out.
Nature is reclaiming, that's right.
Got some more metal behind.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can see where that pipe went into the other tree here. Huh.
Part of the swing set that was going through these valleys in the tree. The tree actually grew up and around the pipe. So that was swinging in that area.
Yeah.
Hey.
There's part of the swing. Part of the swing.
Oh, look at this.
Right between the trees.
Wow.
Part of the base of the swing.
Oh, wow.
That's probably what it was at the time when they
met with that. We would have been standing, this would be someone's yard at the time. You kind of could see how the yards were spaced by the trees or the tree lines. A piece of fence. I'm surprised no one's come up here and like built huts, tree houses, stuff like that out of this stuff.
Yeah.
You don't see too much of that.
It's amazing when all this stuff has just almost disappeared already.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I said I was 14 when I first drove through here.
Yeah.
Seeing the smoke and all up by the church.
Yeah, I remember
I was thinking, oh my God. I've
never seen it on TV back in
the
day.
Mm-hmm.
I was young.
And then I started working back in 89 where I'm at, about 4 miles from here. And go by through here every day making deliveries there. That house is gone, up the speed shop's gone, up the church is gone. I'm thinking, oh boy. And I'm always thinking, what are they gonna do with the cemetery? Especially the one where you see the graves go like this. They're all shifting. And I'm thinking, what are you doing? I don't know, if you wanna be cremated, get buried in Centralia.
I was gonna say, yeah, I could cremate yourself.
Basically, I'm sure.
This is basically a retainer wall for the hillside up there. This area up here was the sports field for the high school. They had the football field, they had their track area. And we can go up there, there's steps right up here. We'll go right
he's going the hard way. Just amazing how empty this area is. You can see there was some houses and stuff, and these are the only remaining houses up here. It's sort of taking you up to the high school.
A lot of people. That would not be me.
Bring a frisbee.
Yeah, good frisbee area. Mow that all down there. Nice frisbee area, picnic area.
Yeah.
They had track here, football. They had basically everything.
I like that stone wall.
Yes.
Is it for the high school?
Yes. Drink a beer at high school.
Uh-oh. Yeah, nothing really left here. Over here, they said there's a remnants of the foundation of a house. And as you can see, sidewalks are hidden in the grass. Yeah. Oh wow. Yep, there it is. That's definitely foundation. I'm standing on the wall. I've been looking down their basement, old stone foundation yet. Yeah, looking like a, I guess a double home. It looks like something right here sinking in, like another foundation for a house here. Yeah, you can kind of tell the plants, what ones are native and what ones aren't. If you're familiar with the plants around here. Yeah, this would have been going, but you right here would have been away in the, basement here. I hope it's safe to be in here. There's a piece of cinder block.
Found it!
Oh. Yeah, look at this little stone here.
Too young. Yeah. We figure I'm 50. Tom Lakaitis is about 49. So if everyone else died, he would still have like another 20 and 30 years before.
Right. So they wanted him out.
They wanted him out, and they let the older people, the senior citizens, like, you know, 55 or over, basically.
Right.
What they did.
That's
the
best
thing, because
they have problems they can't get to.
It was.
Like I said,
the town didn't die from a mine fire. The town died because government corruption.
Okay, we just moseyed our way back down to this building. Remember from the last meetup I was at for the Pioneer Tunnel, we incorporated this building into it up here in Centralia. And we'll just follow around. It started getting a little worse than what I remember it. I don't remember that brick being all busted up over there. And the trees pushing on it. That didn't get on that side. That'll show you how long this has been abandoned. You can see the tree. Now you gotta watch for nails and ticks. Yeah, look at that. Just growing right up. Pushing the wall away. Or should I say pushing the wall in. I guess we can go around this way. Everyone else is in there. Going the door. Yeah, right here it's all charred. Someone was burning. Trying to destroy. Yeah. Yeah, I was just on that side. Look, I didn't notice that last time. I think more of the roof fell down.
Yeah, I think so.
Possible with that snow.
Yeah.
That snow would have done it. Oh, here's something. Oh, that don't go in. I thought it went in there. You got some hooks on the wall here. I don't know if this was a wash house. I don't see.
The wash house was down closer to the Birdsville Colliery.
Oh, okay.
Now, that is a bit, when you're coming up from Ashland, you'll see a big pull-off area on the southbound lane, as well as on the northbound lane. That's where the wash house was.
Oh, okay.
This is some kind of a maintenance building, I think.
Yeah, here's track for Joyce. I saw this last time. Cool. Yeah, something heavy hanging off of this. And we got, I guess this would be air hose.
I think so. There's more. There's a lot more of it.
Yeah.
Inside this little shack.
Yeah, there's a coupler right there.
Yeah, how do you get down to the basement? Around the. Yeah, around the back side there.
There's a shortcut.
Yeah, I was looking at that. And
we'll go in this thing here. I think this is where there was a scale. If you think the road's right over there, and then I'm gonna have to turn the light on. Let me get back to you. Yeah, we'll take you down in this a little bit. Show you what's in here. Ooh, it's nice and cool in here. Yeah, see, it goes back somewhat. And then I'm gonna get my. See, there's this hook right here. And to me, it looked like it pivoted on that at one time. Right up there. I keep going in. Oh, it's tight in here. It's only about 2 by 2 foot by 2 foot. Yeah, see, that goes all the way up and then ends up there. Right above me is all. Yeah, that's a railroad track in there. But then there's like. Yeah, this mechanism looks like it was a. See, there's a hinge right here where it would have hinged off of that. It probably sat there and then this would balance. And then when they put weight on that side, that would activate the scale. Oh, look at the lovely spider. How kind are you? Nice. I don't see too many spider up. There's one hanging there. I gotta watch. Yeah, I'm coming out. I'm in the hole. I'm stuck. Oh, there we go. All right, let's head out. I'm gonna turn you off the head. Get out of here. Oh, nice and cool in here.
Hey, coal cracker.
Hey.
What you doing down there?
I'm looking for coal.
Find it?
Nope.
You found the air conditioning.
Found the air conditioning.
That's something.
It is nice in there. Just two buddies in there.
Did you see what Nick found? And that other one is actually narrow gauge rails as part.
Okay, we just came from that building. They're over there by that building. Yeah. This will take a walk up here and see what these guys are looking at. I want to do a little drone footage if I can. See if I spot. Oh, there's some metal here. Huh. I wonder what that could have been from. And then, yeah, there's a... Huh. Don't know what this was. Got some heavy rebar in it. Yeah, just, I thought those were sticks. That's metal sticking out of the ground there.
A lot of it.
Wow.
I believe we have the collie. It's fairly collie right here.
Oh, okay. Makes sense on the side of a mountain. Oop, watch your step. Oh, yeah. Wow. Some more over here. Huh. Let's go up this way a little bit. And if this were a colliery, was a colliery, they would have built it on the mountain for the natural slope so they could slide the coal down the chutes and the screens. Yeah, some more cement here. Yeah. No, that's not cement. That looks more like rock. That's cement. Definitely. Yeah, it's weird. It's like a... Huh. Hard to say what this was unless you saw a picture of it before it was torn down. There's like this mound of dirt I'm walking on with coal on it. Right here. Yeah. Nice chunk. Stove coal. That size would be. Yeah. Oh, there's some cable. So there might have been a hoist here. Found some cable here.
I also found some rail over here.
Rail?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. There might have been a plane or something here.
Yeah,
just walk up this way a little bit. I think this might be... I don't know. Right next to a dirt road here. There's a piece of pipe. That's an exhaust pipe from a car. Never was up here. Yeah, I said you saw some rail down there. I don't see any more up here. Let's go look over the edge here. Old tire. Like a 13 inch. I don't see anything else up here. Wow, we're up the hill here pretty much. That gets you a good view. And that's just rock. Nothing really up here. But that road that I was following, see, that's like it's a road coming up the hill. Yeah, I have my drone with me just in case I want to fly it. And it just looks like it keeps continuing up this way. I don't want to get too far from the crowd. Let's take a sneak peek down this road quick. Someone's coming up. Yeah, I wonder if this was an inclined plane of some kind. If they found cable. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's like a quarter inch.
It's broken off. Yeah, it doesn't continue over here, does it? It don't look like it does. There's a hole over there by the tree, but that might be just a critter hole. The leaf gets in the way. Yeah, I don't think it went over there. Definitely interesting. Clues, lots of clues. Right over here, some rail sticking up out of the ground along this, I guess they call it an incline. Let's see if this is an actual rail or was it just for an insulator. I bet you this was a slope mine. There's some rock right here, some cement right here. See how it's squared off in the railing? Oh yeah. Yep.
Pipe there. And it looks like we got remnants of the foundation.
Oh yeah, there's some rail. That looks like it was used for...
Yeah.
Yeah, that was just for reinforcement.
Oh, check that out.
Where's Nick?
Nick. The size of that one.
It's intact too.
Look at that one over there.
Yeah.
Adam needs to check this out. I wonder if he knows anything about this.
Ah, oh, that's cool.
I like this.
Yeah, it almost looks like it's a service platform for a train, but the grooves aren't in here. There'd be grooves on the, one of the sides if it was.
Huh. That is a giant insulator.
Yeah, my neighbor had them for planters.
Oh, wow.
He had them upside down and he put plants in them.
Yeah, this looks like some type of duck bank right here.
Yeah.
This goes back to the hill.
Some machinery, it doesn't say what it is.
All kinds of fancy stuff in here. We're going in.
Yeah, bits of hardware. Something was bolted here at one time. Yep, there's the bolts.
What you got over there, Chris?
Some foundation machine was bolted to.
I
wonder if this was a pump house. Starting to think.
How heavy is it?
Yeah.
It's a good 20 pounds right there.
I mean, this is...
They make good... Oh, I got one of them. Those are neat.
I want to get it off the metal.
I keep it on.
I just want the porcelain. Yeah. Like,
you have to take it
home. Uh-huh. Does that say Weston? There's usually a year on them. And the one I found had a year on it.
I'm looking.
It was from Westinghouse. It was smaller than this. But it was from Westinghouse. It doesn't say anything.
Mm-mm. Does that have a date or anything?
It might be something. A manufacturer's
like
date.
20s. Okay. Don't really... pretty heavy.
Don't see any numbers.
It might be on the top.
Yeah.
And a cone. Because you could put a wire up top here.
Yeah, that's where they laid the wire and then wrapped.
Or you could the, you could use, I've seen them do this.
They go in there.
Yeah. But these, 40. These.
But yeah, are but my neighbor had a bunch of these sitting like this. And they had flowers growing up out
that's
of them.
That's awesome. Wish I could take her home, but you know.
Yeah, you this can. You just gotta hoof it.
No, I'm good.
This is coming with me.
Souvenirs. Oh, I pick up railroad spikes and all kinds of little.
Oh, yeah, me too.
You see the hole over here?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this must have been. Trying to think, you know, when I seen breakers, they usually have big columns.
Here you go.
Here's some more.
Found a big ant's nest.
It's like cable. I don't know what this was. Some kind of cable.
Yeah. Looks like old asbestos coated.
Oh, great. I'm handling it.
That's all good. Yeah, it definitely looks like
I don't know. And there's a pipe here. There's an insulator for you.
Yeah, there's the big one.
I didn't even see that till now. Yeah, more foundation. Looks like, yeah, there's something bolted here. See the bolts here? There's one. Usually in the corners. Yeah, there was a big something here.
That is something.
There you go.
Wow. Hey, let's check this one out.
Pretty much intact.
Yeah.
They make good candle holders.
Yeah.
This thing.
I might be able to get away taking this one.
That'd be the one to take home right there.
Yeah, this would look great in the living room. Don't know if Nikki would like it or not, but that's all right.
You need to get yourself some the transformers from Neon Signs.
Uh-huh.
Run a wire from each wire straight up. Plug it in, it goes.
That water there, you go up on the hill there, there's a pipe, and the water's come out of that pipe.
Oh.
And the pipe looks like that rusty one right there.
Oh, wow.
But like right up there.
Now that might have been.
See the telephone pole right up
there?
If
this was a breaker or a collieries, there was a water source to wash the coal
in. Yeah, there's a pipe that goes this way, and it's got a crack in the side of it.
It's not orange. Yeah, a little spring here. Let's take a look. There's some metal laying here. A lot of scrap metal, if anything. Shale bank. Yeah, it just comes out from under that rock. Oh, no, it don't. It goes under the rock, but it goes over this way. I don't really see anything. Let's go up top here. This looks like a... Ah, there's another pipe here. Huh.
You see what I'm talking about? You see it?
Yeah.
I think it comes to the stop right there,
though. Yeah. Now, water, let's get up here a minute. Oh, wow. Yeah, here's the water source of the pipe up here, too. Found a neat little fishing spot. Never knew this was here. Oh, okay, I know where we're at. 61's right over there. So this... I found the pool! Yeah. Yeah, there's definitely electrical up here. With the guy wire system, you see. Go through this way. This is cool. Definitely gotta check for ticks when I get home. Oh, wow. This keeps continuing over here. A little tunnel to walk through. Oh. Sticker bush tunnel. Ow. Oh, wow. This is cool. Yeah, I don't know what's over here. Just the water. Now, I hear water across there. Over in there. Yeah, I don't know if I'd want to swim in this. But yeah, definitely. Don't see any ticks crawling on me yet. Keep checking. You going woods later? Yeah. They're just right on top of Matt. No, not Matt. Nick. Grab my hat. Got snagged on the trees up here. Yeah. Just going around like a some slate. Yeah, it's like a dam. They would have had a water source for washing the coal. Yeah, very cool. Yeah, it just comes out here then. Quick look where this path goes. This is where that pipe was that Matt told me about or pointed out. Just go up here. Does it go up or does it just go around? I won't stray too far from the crowd. Yeah, it's over there. Is that water? Oh, look at the pretty blue, purple flowers up there. Neat. Yeah, can't go too far in this road. Yeah, it just keeps going. Right, let me get back to the gang. Watch where you step here, because you'll go down and not come back up. Yeah. Just following this road with Jake Smith now. following the road, see where it goes. So far, deeper into the woods.
Come